Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for March the 7th of 2021, well, it is titled Pillars of the Eagle Nebula in Infrared. So what do we see here? Well, this is a famous image from Hubble Space Telescope known as the Pillars of Creation, and the great pillars stretching upward. And if it looks a little bit different than perhaps other images of this that you've seen, that's because instead of being taken in visible light, ordinary light that we're used to seeing, this is taking in slightly longer wavelengths of the infrared. So Hubble Space Telescope, which took this image, is able to look in some of the infrared and some of the ultraviolet portion of the spectrum as well. Now, when we look at infrared, longer wavelengths are better able to penetrate dust. So we're actually able to see through the nebula. And that's why the leftmost pillar is almost invisible. It had the least dust there, so we're able to see through it relatively well, except for a few of the denser places that are still standing out. And those are denser areas of dust, which are still blocking out even the slightly longer wavelengths of infrared radiation. And the longer the wavelength, the better it is able to penetrate dust like this. So even longer wavelengths of infrared allow us to a peek into the star forming regions in the galaxy. That allows us to see through the dust. So for visible light, we're kind of stuck. We can't see through the dusty areas and see what's going on inside. When we look with an infrared telescope, we can actually peer through the dust and kind of get a view through the wall that the dust provides and let us see that stellar nursery where new stars are forming. If we wait the hundreds of thousands of years it will take for them to become visible, to break through that dust and become visible to us, then we will lose some of the information. So in order to be able to study the very earliest stages of star formation, we do need to use infrared telescopes. And it's one of the ways astronomy has advanced rapidly with the space age, by being able to get satellites up in orbit. Hubble Space Telescope being one of these, but also other satellites that observe other wavelengths of light and allow us to get a more complete picture of the universe and to see things like this that we would be unable to see at all from the ground. So ordinary optical ground-based telescopes would not be able to give us the kind of detail that we see here and this peek into a stellar nursery. So that was our picture of the day for March the 7th of 2021. It was titled Pillars of the Eagle Nebula in Infrared. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be a comet's red tail. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.